Hey, what's up, guys? This is JR Hatchlife coming at you guys with a video of some Gran Turismo 6 gameplay and the overview. Very good games, similar to Gran Turismo 5, nothing like a big dramatic change or anything. One thing that I noticed right off when I started playing is it gives you an odometer now. As you can see right there, my car has 5 miles. So I guess right there you can see how many miles your car has now. That's pretty cool to me. I'm not sure how many cars are premium, but I'm guessing most of them are, since all the cars are bought on the dealer. I haven't seen a used car dealer so far. One thing I also noticed is the car, the way it reacts. It's right here, I don't know if you can see, it's kind of leaning more to the side. So it's more realistic, I guess. One thing that hasn't changed that I'm hoping there's an update for is the sound of the car hasn't changed. Here it is. Then so much different. One thing I did notice is that you could change the color of your gauges. There's also a blind spot indicator. I haven't really experienced that. I don't know how that works, but yeah, there's that. And here's the gauge colors. You could change it. As you see right here, I changed it to red, and there's different colors like cobalt blue and stuff like that. And you can see that it changes the colors of the numbers on your gauge. You could also change the ring color, the color behind it, and you see right there. You can't really tell in here since I'm doing off-screen recording that it changed to blue. I go through a few other colors, but I thought that was pretty cool. Here's kind of a overlook of the menu and stuff. Here's a Acura that I went through some of the cars, but not most. I just went through like the Acura and the Honda, the cars that I mostly use. I noticed that the cars did get more horsepower. I don't know if you noticed, but the Acura and Integra, the USDM one, the Type R, it has 195 horsepower stock, which I believe is more than Gran Turismo 5. These are the cars, basically the same thing. I haven't really noticed a change. I just noticed that they're Type R's, Integras, the DC2s, they all have the same horsepower. And in the Gran Turismo 5, they had different horsepower. The years, like I think the 98 had the lowest horsepower, but in this one, the only thing that changes is the amount of torque that it has. But yeah, there's not much difference in the cars, basically all the same thing. Right here, I'm gonna go through the aerial parts. All right, here I messed up in the video. I forgot that I had another car. I was gonna show you the parts on the fit, but I'm gonna switch it up. The Mercedes that I have right now, you could get that one for free. I'm gonna show later on in the video how to get it. I'm gonna get the fit. I've noticed that there's this thing called move to, I don't know what it is, a stockyard. I don't know. I'm guessing it's like a some type of other garage or something. I don't know what that is. But I'm moving my Mercedes right now to the stockyard. Just fast forward this. Excuse me. I moved it to the stockyard, and I don't know, right there in the stockyard, but I'm not too sure what that is. Hopefully I figure it out later on. Or if some of you guys know, comment what it is. Let me fast forward this part because it takes quite a while. Okay, now that I got the fit, I'm gonna show you guys the aerial parts and the rims. Fast forward this part also because it takes a while. Alright, so now I'm gonna show you guys the add-ons on the tuning parts. Nothing changed on the tires. The only difference that I noticed is that there's on the racing tires, they added like a different rain type of tire, I guess, like rain heavy or light or whatever. The suspension, the only thing that I noticed is suspension rally. I'm guessing that's for rally cars. I'm not too sure, I haven't used it. They also added racing brakes. I accidentally bought that, but yeah, they had racing brakes. The drivetrain, it's pretty much the same. Nothing has really changed. Same thing. The only thing that changes on the clutch, it has a triple play clutch, so I'm guessing you can shift faster. Besides that, everything's the same. The power, everything's the same also. The only thing I noticed is the intake tuning. I guess you can't add, like, I don't know if you guys remember how you were able to add, like, the intake on its own or the manifold or whatever. I'm guessing that comes in a package. This is also something I noticed. I'm not sure you guys are going to react to this, but there's nitrous on it. I don't think you have to pay for it to be refilled. I think it refills on its own, but yeah, that's something that I've noticed there. On the body, everything else is the same also. Yeah, nothing, I mean, it's different, I guess, but nothing has really changed. Now here's the aerial parts. I noticed you could add lips to the cars. I think that was pretty cool. I'm not sure if you could add it to all the cars, but right on the Fit you could. There you could see the Type A lip and the Type B lip. The Type B lip adds like a diffuser to the back. I don't know if you guys can see it right there, but it adds a diffuser to the back. They added a lot of rims. I think that was better, and you could also change the size of the rims. I think changing the size of the rims is something cool they added, because on some cars you might want bigger rims than others. They did add a lot of different rims, and I'm hoping that you could use all the rims on all the cars, not like before there were certain rims that you could use on certain cars. I go through some of them. I go through, well, actually most, but they did add a good amount of rims, which I thought was a good idea. Finally, instead of just having like a section of five rims where you could choose from, they added a concave T37s in here. I thought it was pretty cool. Yeah, well, there's a lot of rims. That was a good idea, something they added to it. I'm going through some of the rims here. I'm going through them pretty quick. I'm not too sure how many rims there is, but there's a lot. Yeah, well, there's a lot of the rims. I'm still going through a few of them right here. I mean, that's something I like, because a lot of you guys probably make your car stanced and whatnot, and you guys didn't have much choices of rims to go through. That's something that changed. I'm keep on going through some of the rims. There's quite a selection to choose from. And as you can see right there, there is a lot of rims. That BBSs, they had those in the other game also. Little muscle car rims. Alright, here I go through this thing called Vision GT. It's kind of like, I forgot what it's called, but the little cards where you earn the cards and you can see the pictures of the cars. Instead, right here, they have like different stuff, like Honda. I'm not sure what car that is. I guess it's some type of Honda concept. They have like little sketches of the cars, I guess, when they were making them and stuff. And I go through the Mercedes ones. This is the only one that you could go through in the beginning. And I'm gonna show you guys, has like a little movie to it. You guys can watch this. Yeah, that's the video. It's pretty cool. I cut it short. You guys could watch the rest if you guys like. They also show the team, I guess, who built the car, and sketches of, I guess, how they went designing the car. It has cool little features like this. You guys get bored of racing or something, I don't know, you guys could go through them and watch them. Hopefully they put the other sketches and the other videos of the cars, of the other cars. That'd be pretty cool. Yeah, there's the sketches. I told you I was gonna show you guys how to get that car for free. Right there where it says purchase, I already purchased the car, I guess, kind of purchased it, but whatever. You get it for free, you just click on that, and it says something about you can only get the car once. So yeah, you just go right there and you can get that car for free. I'm not sure if you could sell it or not, but I know it's worth $1 million, so I'm pretty sure you could get some money for it. They have a lot of other stuff, like, I don't know, they have a Jordan thing right there. I'm not sure what else they have, but they have a lot of stuff. I'm not too sure what's gonna be there. I go to the paint, but I had no paint except one since I just started the game. But yeah, it's basically the same thing. Got a metallic, pearl scent, color shift, matte, chrome, solid. Basically the same thing. You could also paint the rims, same thing also. That didn't change. I'm not sure if they're gonna have the same color, the same paint or whatever. I'm guessing they will. Yeah, it's basically the same thing also. You can wash your car, change the oil, improve the body rigidity, to restore the body, and overhaul the engine. Kind of the same thing. Not much has changed in that way. Yeah, just go through that. So that didn't change. Once again, I'm doing off-screen recording, so bear with me, the quality is not that great. You could change your gear, like your racing gear, same thing also. You could change your helmet, I'm guessing your racing suit. That special outfit, I didn't go to that. But yeah, that's about it. Oh, they also recommend cars for the races. I know that they didn't have that before, but they recommend cars for, like, what car you should use for that race. I'm guessing that's something pretty cool too. Say you're lost, or I got stuck in a couple of races on GT5. So yeah, you could just go through there. They also have trucks right there. Seen the Range Rover. I know they had trucks on GT5, but it wasn't trucks like that. It was more pickups. I noticed they have Cadillac. I don't think they had Cadillac in GT5. Buick also, I don't think they had that. I noticed they do have more cars. I've noticed that they have a lot more cars. Also, it tells you, like, on the bottom when you click on the car, I forgot what it says, but it tells you if the car comes stock turbo or not with the turbo. I know that was different. Yeah, the game overall, I like it better. And I haven't played online yet, so I don't know how it is. I noticed they added Bentley, but there's only, like, the Bentley race car. I'm not sure if they're gonna have, like, the Continental GT or whatever. So I'm not sure, hopefully with the updates. The noise, the sound of the cars didn't really change. Hopefully they do an update to change the noise of the car so it could sound a little better. But overall, yeah, I like it better. It's a good game. Hopefully there's more updates to it to get better. And I'm out of here, guys. Thanks for watching. Subscribe and like the video. Give it a thumbs up.